Alright, so after a long hiatus, I'm back. I'll be playing the new Wartune Ultra mobile game, which is another iteration of our favorite game. You'll also notice that I am using a voice which I don't know if you'd have guessed right, but it is from a text-to-speech software that is free. Anyways, the real reason I didn't play this game at launch was because it's not available in my region. It still isn't, and I had to get the APK from one of the APK sites in order to play the game. I wish they'd make it available for all regions from the get-go, but oh well. At least now it is available in Europe, and that's where I plan on starting this new account or tune. I think I tried to play this exact game on the PC version, but it was just the loading screen, and I got bored. First of all, the loading screen girl is kind of hot. I'm sorry, I know it's just a pixelated screen. First of all, I signed in using my existing Google account because I do plan on playing this game and more some more content on it since I'm something of a content creator now. I would also like to know how you guys feel about the new voice as opposed to the text caption I used to use. When it came to the class, I honestly didn't know which one I should pick. The mage is always the most versatile option because of the area attacks and healing, making it the most beginner-friendly. With the archer, the damage burst is unmatched, and with the knight, the tankiness is pretty good. With the first iteration of this game, I picked the mage, and there's more content on her on the channel. With the reborn version, I picked the knight, but I ended up ditching her for another tune in the regular PC Wartune where I picked an archer. I figured since the reborn one didn't get too far game-wise, I could continue with her through this new account. These new figures for the classes are not bad, but nothing beats the original one. The beginning of the game is the same old stuff we're seen so many times. You fight some bears, then you meet Dinah, then you go to your city, or is it a town? It's your castle, and I don't know if you're the king or queen or the commander. I have never known how the politics goes along in such games. The first thing you notice versus the original Wartune Hall of Heroes is that, visual, it's a sort of downgrade. It's not terrible per se, but the original one did it better. Same with the skill user interface. It's functional, but the other one had a visible rage and health half circle that filled up or reduce, not a line bar graph thing with numbers on it. If you've played this game before, you know the usual dance or lingo that goes along with these first few missions where your troops are stronger than you. Something that I have noticed is that they seem to have reduced the difficulty, because I wasn't quite min-maxing, but none of the dungeons gave me an issue. Well, I did die on the mage boss. Everything seems to use gold as the primary currency when it comes to upgrading your buildings, troops, and academy. I like that Daru and Kyanite are usually a bottleneck early on, and not having to worry about them is a welcome change. It seems the buildings don't have cooldowns, which is another nice quality of life change, because I get that the game can squeeze some extra revenue through the VIP system, but still. I mentioned before that this game isn't available on my region, and seeing as I have access to it means that region look is kind of BS, but there was another hurdle. Unlike when the original game came on, or rather, when I was playing it, I was younger, I didn't have job or any disposable cash, but now I do. I would like to support the game, buy some really nice packs, which should give me a decent head start, but I can't. Google won't take my money because the game technically isn't available in my region. I don't mind being a free-to-play, but for a point in my life where I do have some disposable income, I would like to utilize it. There's also a bunch of events going on because this server launched like 4 days ago, so if you want to start playing the game, this would be a nice time to start. I can't give a general review of the game because I just started playing it. I will keep on pumping out content, and if you have questions or anything, feel free to comment below. A matter of fact, like share, subscribe, and all that nice YouTube stuff. I don't know if this is where the video ends, but yeah. Thanks for watching. Okay, so it's not the end of the video. I decided to write a script first, and I thought it could stretch me to like 10 minutes, but that's not the case as it is barely 4 minutes, but I do want the video to be a lot longer. The thing with Wartune is, it is a game you like me have played it so many times, so the first few interactions with you don't wow you as much. This is a game built for nostalgia, and it is what brought me back. It's still the core Wartune elements and not bloated like the PC version. I did enjoy the PC version at some point, but man, did it feel like there's just too much going on, which, though not bad for existing players, it's pretty terrible for newer player. This, on the other hand, has few stuff, or at least I'm hoping it has few stuff. I'm aware of Sylphs being around, but not much else. I do know that the Wartune Reborn didn't have class advancement, and in terms of unnecessary fat, it just didn't have it. A big reason why I stopped playing Wartune Reborn, or the re-release as I called it, was having to run a multiplayer dungeon like so many times without having a reliable team or specific players, whether they run with you or help you, just kind of sour my experience. With the PC version, getting help was fairly easy, especially after the first merge, and I liked the sense of progression. This one, the Wartune Ultra, is a step in the right direction. I've mentioned the lack of cooldowns on buildings, the only currency being gold, which you get lots of. It feels like you level up quicker or you don't need as much EXP. Blitzing dungeons happens in an instant instead of 5 minutes. It feels like you can autoplay damn near everything, which, for better or for worse, is good, I guess. And the server is actually full of people. Granted, this is a new server. I decided to pick the Europe server because they're 2 hours behind us, meaning I won't have to squeeze myself around the in-game time stuff. With the American servers, most stuff would be happening at night, which I wouldn't want. The in-game purchases are really nice, with there being an in-game purchase for $1, which should give you the fancy first-time purchase stuff, which are nice. The rest of the packs are also pretty good, granted they're probably that way because of the new server. My downsides are that the user interface just isn't quite as good as the Hall of Heroes version. I don't know why they changed it, like they could have just ripped that old version and updated it with new stuff, and everyone would be happy. Another downside is I joined too late and couldn't get into the top guilds because they were full. I can look past some of my complaints and try to enjoy the game. These are my day one thoughts, impressions, and look at the game.